I guess that we might get to work, so I'm going to get to work. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
It's wonderful to be in God's house today, isn't it?
Amen.
And a beautiful sunny day that God's given us after three or four dreary old cold rainy days. I couldn't help but think Friday, just probably what a similar day that we had Friday to the day that Christ was crucified. Oh, dark, dreary, and I know it turned completely dark that day, but just dreary and depressing. It was a terrible, terrible day for what he had to go through for his disciples and family. But as the old preacher said, Sunday's coming. And everything changed on Sunday morning.
Yes.
And for all of us. If he hadn't have came out of that grave, we wouldn't be saved right now. He wouldn't have been who he said he was, would he? And I'm so thankful that Christ arose. Hitchy Baptist Hymnal, I want to ask you all if you would to stand with us today. And I want you to turn over to number 160. And lo, in the grave he lay, up from the grave he rose.
Thank you.
one, turn over to number 407, Because He Lives. One of Bill Gaither's best songs, I think, and hope you enjoy singing it with us this morning.
But even before we do that, or after I do that, I want to do something special this morning. We had our Easter egg hunt yesterday, and we had about 100 show up, probably 30-something kids, and the rest of the adults were all helping with it, which I do so much greatly appreciate everybody who's coming out and supporting it. But we had something happen yesterday afternoon at the Easter egg hunt that needs to be proclaimed.
Amen.
Yeah.
Brent, would you come up here, please? This is Brent Myers. His mama, his grandmama, his granddaddy sit back there, and his stepfather. Brent, they called me on Friday and said, Brent wants to go to heaven. And he said, when can we talk? I said, just bring him tomorrow to the Easter egg hunt. And I said, we'll go one-on-one and we'll talk to him. So I took him downstairs and I talked to him and I said, Brent, now why is it you want to get saved? He said, because I don't want to go to hell. So I explained it to him from the Word of God, how you get saved and what Jesus did for him. He prayed the prayer and asked Jesus to forgive him of his sins and come into his heart and life and be his personal Savior.
Yes.
And he accepted Christ right then and right there. Yes.
There's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. And the white robed angels sing the story, a sinner has come home. For there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. With my sins forgiven, I am bound for heaven, never more to roam.
Amen.
Amen.
Not only that, you're going to get baptized. We're going to go out of ranks that in a couple of weeks and have a baptism. Get the young girl that was saved a couple of weeks ago and get her. Thank you, church, for praying. Thank you for being who you are. God bless you. Okay, Mike, it's all you.
I love that. Ushers, will y'all come this time? Thank you. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us. Thank you, Lord, for coming to this earth and going through what you did. To carry your cross up the hill, to willingly lay your life down so that we could become yours and go to heaven someday, Lord. Thank you for paying for our sins, Jesus. We owe you more than we could ever do back to you, Father. We thank you for this church, Lord. Thank you for each and every person that's here today, Father. We ask your richest of blessings on me. We thank you for a beautiful, beautiful day, Lord, that reminds us so much of what the Bible talks about when you came out of that grave, Lord, and arose for our justification. We love you, Jesus. We thank you for everything that you've done for us. Bless this service. Bless the singing. Bless the preaching. In your name we pray. Amen. Thank you. first special today.
I'm going to leave that oxygen off and just pray that the Lord will give me the air that I need. He's never failed me. I used to be in Loxton 24/7, and whenever I got ready to sing, I just asked the Lord to give me the air that I needed, and He has never failed me. And that thing makes such a racket, I don't want to hold it up here, so you all be hearing it every time it goes hiss. So I want this to listen to this song. Please don't listen to the way I sing this morning, because I may run out of air, but just this song says, He's alive.
Then my mind went soaring back to
I don't know about this gang here. Destiny was, even as a little child, You know, and it had to be hard on the human part of it. But it also had to be hard on the God part of it. Knowing that someday, and he knew the exact day, he knew the exact time, he knew exactly how everything was going to happen. He knew that he had to pay for our sins.
Yeah.
That was his purpose in coming here. It wasn't to come and take over the Roman Empire, as many thought that that's what the Messiah was going to do. He's going to be a man of war, but he turned out to be exactly the opposite. He turned out to be a man of love. Loved everybody. He loved the old beggar that sat on the side of the street, the leper, the ones who were lame, the adulteress. I was watching the movie last night, The Bible, and I know some of y'all seen that, just made a few years ago. And they brought in a woman caught in adultery. There wasn't any doubt that she was guilty. He knew that. He picked up a rock and said, "Let he who's without sin among you first cast a stone at him." Well, those rocks went to hit in the ground. You know why? We all sin. We all sin. But you know what? He loves us all.
Yes.
In spite of ourselves. That he came to this world not to do miracles, not to do things like that, but his destiny and what he was here for was to die on the cross.
Amen.
Hope you enjoyed this. We'll do the best we can. It's been a long time.
Babe would someday die to set me free.
behind.